So here what you see is a line segment AB, and its midpoint is labeled as M. Okay. So we know that AM is equal to MB, okay, because the midpoint divides the segment AB into two equal parts. Okay, we can also create a right triangle for this AB segment, treating AB as a hypotenuse, and we can do the same thing for AM and AMB. Okay, we can make right triangles for each. Okay, and now notice how we can label each component of each equal subsegments as A. We can have this vertical component B, this vertical component C, and this vertical component D. Okay, this would be B. Notice now that since we have a 90 degree angle, and the hypotenuses will be the same in both of these smaller right triangles, and since it's a straight line segment, then A must be equal to C. Okay, basically these components, B is equal to D and C is equal to A. Okay, and for this reason we can say that if we draw a hypotenuse here for this right triangle, we will also have the same hypotenuse. Okay, we can also show how A is equal to C by knowing that since this is going to be the same hypotenuse, and obviously there's parallelism involved, okay, we can say that using the slope property that B over A is equal to B over C. Okay, the slope of this line segment AM, B over A, is equal to the slope of this line segment that we just drew, B over C. Okay. And again, this is coming from the fact that this is a straight line and midpoint M divides this line segment AB into equal parts, and we treat each equal part as a hypotenuse. So we are talking about the same hypotenuses and right triangles with those hypotenuses. Okay, and since this is a straight line, the components are such that A is equal to C and B is equal to D. All right, and once again, using the slope property, B over A is equal to B over C, and cross multiplication gives us AB is equal to BC. And notice that if we divide both sides by B, we will get A is equal to C. Okay, and that's precisely what we wanted to know. And also realize that D over C, right, this right triangle, using the slope property, D over C is equal to B over C. Okay? And multiplying both sides by C eliminates the C's, right, and D is equal to B. And that's another fact that we've derived before, based on the fact that this is a straight line, it's a line segment, the hypotenuses are the same, so the components must be the same. A is equal to C and B is equal to D, right? So we use the parallelism and the slope of these subsegments to show how A is equal to C and D is equal to B. Okay, so now how does that help us prove the midpoint formula? Well, we can draw this line segment again. Okay, and we know that the midpoint is M. Okay, and now we're going to label each vertex of each triangle, basically, with X's and Y's. Okay, so let's label this as X1, Y1. Let's label this vertex here, well, it's not really, well, it is a vertex of a smaller triangle. Let's label it as X, Y1, okay. We'll just name it X because this is the X coordinate of the midpoint. Okay, that's why we just call it X. And this vertex we'll call X2, Y1. Okay. Now the midpoint formula, the midpoint coordinates will have coordinates x, comma y. Okay. And this vertex will be x2, comma y. And the top vertex, which is the endpoint of the original line segment AB, will be x2, y2. Okay? So now remember that A was equal to C and B was equal to D. So knowing that A is equal to C, okay, we're going to express A in terms of the difference of the x coordinates. And so is going to be for C. So we're going to set this difference equal, and this will show that A is equal to C. Okay, so we're going to have to do x minus x1 is equal to x2 minus x. Okay, so we're just expressing this distance in terms of the difference of the x coordinates here. Okay, so now if we add the x on both sides and add the x1 on both sides, we're going to have 2x is equal to x1 plus x2, right? Dividing both sides by 2 yields us x is equal to x1 plus x2 over 2. Okay, so notice that we already proved the midpoint formula x coordinate here. Okay, now the y coordinate follows the same rule. We're taking the fact that d is equal to b, the fact we've derived before. And for this reason, we can work with the y-coordinates the same way. Okay, so we're going to express d and b by subtracting one y-coordinate from the other and doing the same thing on both sides of the equation. Okay, so we're going to take the top part first. So the top part, the d part, is going to be expressed as y2 minus y, and now equals the b distance, right? Now the b distance is going to be y minus y1, right? Y minus y1. So now again, we're going to add y on both sides and add y1 on both sides as well. And what we get will be y1 plus y2 is equal to 2y. Dividing both sides by 2 gives us the y coordinate of the midpoint, right? It's going to be y1 plus y2 over 2. Okay, so we just proved that the coordinates are indeed what they are for the midpoint, but we proved it for the line segment that follows a positive slope. It's relatively easy, and it's the same thing when you're following the case where the slope is negative, okay, where the line falls from left to right. But I'm not going to go over it here. I'm just going to go over the case where the line is horizontal and vertical. So if the line is horizontal and there's a midpoint M here with coordinates x, comma y, and here the coordinates will be x2, y2, and then x1, y1. Again, the midpoint guarantees that these subsegments are divided into are going to be equal, right? Because we're dividing the original segment into two equal parts, right? So for algebraically, we're doing the same thing. We're saying that x minus x1 is equal to x2 minus x. And again, adding x on both sides, notice that we're arriving at this answer here. So I'm just going to show you that it's going to be the same thing. So x is going to be equal to x1 plus x2 over 2. Now notice that if you work with the y's, you're not moving the y coordinates when you're talking about a horizontal line. Okay? So it will give you a zero result, because if you subtract basically y2 and y and y1 are all equal. Okay? So if you try to subtract one from the other, you will get a zero result. And zero does equal zero. And it just shows you that it's true, because if you plug it in here, basically y2 minus y is 0. Okay, so I'll show you what I mean here. So y2 minus y, minus y is going to be equal to y minus y1. Okay, basically what we do is I'm just gonna cross this out for a second. If you understand that y2 is equal to yn equal to y1, in the case where the line is horizontal, then you can treat these y's all the same. So you can have y is equal to y plus y over 2. Okay, and it makes sense because on the right side here you will have 2y over 2, and 2y over 2 is y. Okay, so it just makes sense. Okay, this formula still holds. The case where the line is vertical follows the same rule. Now in this case the x's will be the same. Okay, so x 2, y 2, for the midpoint we will have x, y, and for the bottom endpoint we have x 1, y 1. Now in this case again you will have the fact that x 2 is equal to x 1 is equal to x and is equal to x 1, right? So you will have x is equal to x plus x over 2. You could do that, right? Because all x's are equal. So you can substitute 1 for all 3 of them. So as a result, you have 2x over 2, which is gives you x, right? So this formula still holds. Now for the y, it's going to be the same thing, okay? You're going to use the formula y2 minus y is equal to y minus y1. Okay, so if you solve for y here, you will have y1 plus y2 is equal to 2. And again, showing you that indeed this formula for the midpoint works and it's true and it does indeed make sense. So thanks for watching. I hope this was helpful. Please subscribe and I'll see you in my next video.